All right. Let's try out this new game I just got. It's a little bit different than anything I've played before. It is a thriller, or psychological thriller is what it's considered to be, but it looked really interesting when I saw the trailers for it. Just looking at the stuff in the glass. Brain. Wards. Multiple wards. Yeah, it does sound like elevator music. This is a psychological thriller. It seemed to be, from the trailer, something close to Layers of Fear, only you go into their mind instead of in your own. I thought I'd try it out, see how... Thank you. Oh, for a second there, I thought it said your first registration. I missed the day part. Computers. Okay, so I guess I'm going in that way. What's over here? A list of doctors. Alright. Heading to the staff only area. It's this way. Whoa. Okay. Oh, look. That must be my office. Yeah. Okay, welcome letter. So, you're playing a neural prober. So basically a shrink. and you dive into the minds of your patients. And depending on the type of trauma that they have will change how they how it looks inside their mind, basically. What's this over here? Ooh, notes. But I cannot open them yet. Oh, I guess this is where I can select the client. Thank you. going through some of this stuff real quick. Oh, whoop, I didn't want to do that. Intro sim. Alrighty. Let's give it a go. Ah, doesn't this part look very peaceful? Somehow I don't think the next one's going to be quite so. Alright. Oh, it's just a big empty room. I guess not quite that big. Alright. It kind of has an Animus vibe from Assassin's Creed to it.
The intro sim is a simulated mindscape created by the Neurostalgia Institute to ensure new neuroprobers are fully prepared before working with their first client. Although not as complex as an actual client, the intro sim offers unique guidance to train and remind neuroprobers of the key principles and techniques of neuroprobing. We at the Neurostalgia Institute hope you enjoy this introductory simulation.
Things have become almost unbearable for me, and for my family. Nothing has helped. I guess that's why I'm here. So, if I just talk about my troubles, you'll be able to use it later to help with the procedure? Seems hard to believe, but you're the experts. I think many of my issues started when I was young. So, why don't we start with my childhood days, yes? Okay, let's see. I was raised in a lovely cottage in rural Germany. We didn't have much, but my twin sister, our father and I got by. There was actually a great famine for much of my early childhood, and often we went without food. I had many happy moments with my family, but the darkest times began when my father remarried. My stepmother always resented my sister.
Yeah.
We didn't like her much either, to be honest.
Basically.
God, she was horrible.
A lot to do with
it. Sometimes she would take my sister and me out for long walks in the forest, and then she'd hurry home. My sister and I couldn't keep up, and we'd often get lost. We learned to leave a trail of whatever we could find on those walks to help us get home. I guess, in some ways, our stepmother helped us become resourceful like that. My sister is a real fighter. The kind of woman any girl or boy could look up to. She volunteers to work with various youth organizations now. Enough about her. Okay, what else? Maybe I should talk about my feelings, yes? You may find it hard to believe, but I've always struggled with various eating disorders and anxiety around food. Eating anything rich makes me feel scared and anxious? It's hard to describe. My sister has actually experienced similar issues, and it has worsened for us both as we've gotten older. That's not normal, no, is it? We've seen countless doctors about this in the past. They've determined that our issues may be trauma-related, but have yet to help us sort out the underlying source. They have yet to fix us? That's why we're here.
Welcome to NeuroProber Training. I am pleased to be your guide. When I'm speaking, you can always make a left trigger motion to skip the instruction. Welcome to NeuroProber Training.
Oh, we already got that one. Okay.
Whether you are speaking with the client directly or neural probing within their mind, it is always imperative to listen. You'll find that every detail of the subconscious is trying to tell its story. In the case of our clients, it's often the forgotten story of the trauma they experienced. Some parts of the client's memory may have become confused or corrupted by the conscious mind's attempts to reconcile or cover up the truth of what happened to them. However, if you look closely and carefully in the right places, you will find that the truth will ultimately shine through.
Ah, what a peaceful area. And there's bread.
Some parts of the subconscious allow you to interact with them. While neuroprobing, make an A button motion to engage with it. Using a right stick motion will allow you to move the item around to examine it further. When you are done, you can make an A motion again, and it will return to its natural position.
More stuff.
While neuroprobing, you will encounter objects that look like photographs. This is how your consciousness interprets the concrete memory moments it finds within the client's psyche. Typically, there are about 10 of these memory photos found in each psyche. The mind can only hold on to so much. You'll find that half of these photos present an actual moment relating to the trauma. The other half tend to be false memories created by the client's conscious mind. It will ultimately be up to you to determine which are which. More on that later. When you acknowledge a memory photo, it will surface more prominently in the client's psyche, the client's mind. When you have found all 10 photos, you must put 5 of the memories that actually represent the trauma in the proper order. Doing so will, at last, fully release the memory to the client's conscious mind. Often, he or she will experience a breakthrough at this moment. That breakthrough is what every neuroprober lives for and is the key to the client finally being able to work towards true recovery. The most important thing you do as a neuroprober is find and acknowledge these photos. However, this is easier said than done. While some photos are freely available in the subconscious, others are buried deeply within and will need to be coaxed out.
That's... Oh, Lord. Thank you.
Interacting with one part of the mind can sometimes open up new areas of the psyche. Some things, like these doors, can change their state in response to actions taken elsewhere.
Oh, that doesn't sound ominous, does it? All right.
The subconscious doesn't take kindly to intruders, and will take every opportunity to feed off of any sensations of anxiety or tension you offer to it. If you can, try to stay calm and peaceful, even in the face of terror. If you can calm yourself, you'll find the subconscious will calm itself too. Here's an example of a particularly buried memory. Some details of a given trauma can be especially tenacious, but by gently and cleverly listening to the clues the mind gives you, you will find all you need to work through it. Just think of it as a puzzle for you to solve. When you focus on these puzzles, make a left trigger motion if you need to break your concentration. Spotty mushrooms. Is it just me, or does this story have like a Hansel and Gretel vibe to it? And creepy dolls hanging from a tree. Alrighty then. Now dolls are falling. Alrighty. Ooh, a memory.
While neuroprobing, your consciousness is lost deep inside the subconscious mind of the client.
Though this is a journey that you must make alone, we at the Neurostalgia Institute take the safety of our neuroprobers very seriously. If you need to access any of your neuroprober tools or pull your consciousness free, press your finger where a menu button might be. This will bring up your neuroprober tools and you can proceed as needed from there.
Okay, so it's the start menu, the start button. All right. Oh, I thought that was another one over there. Like, wait a minute. Okay, so we got 5 more to go. Yay! Yeah, definitely a Grimm's Brother feel to this warped story. Alright, let's see. Into the next section.
Do you remember when I mentioned that the client's subconsciousness can feed off of your fear? Uh-oh. Some uniquely vulnerable areas can be very sensitive and dangerous. When you place your consciousness in another's subconsciousness, there is a risk of you getting hurt, of the pain and turmoil of the client's psyche drawing your own mind into its agony. You must be brave in these areas despite the risk. You must stay calm. Should you let your fears get the best of you, it will be incredibly difficult to proceed unharmed.
Wait, this one doesn't have a clear path. I hear stuff moving. I have no idea where I'm going.
You can even pick up and walk around with some objects. To do so, interact with it, and then start walking while holding on to it.
Thank you. I'm such a dork. Okay. I guess back to the way I came. Oh, water in the bridge. Okay, I don't remember this. Did it change? It had to. Please tell me that's a statue. And now it's snowing. Alrighty then. Am I supposed to go this way? No, that is a cage. Go near the creepy cage. I don't see anything that I need to do with it. It is supposed to be scary, but considering this is just a tutorial, probably not so much. What's this thing? That is another statue. Alright. That is another cage. Although the walking in the background that I keep hearing does not make this the most pleasant little trip I've ever been on. I know there's something following me.
Remember, this is just a simulation created by the Neurostalgia Institute. The psyches of actual clients will likely be more complex and often much more terrifying.
See? Much more terrifying. Just because this is a simulation. Yay! So there was a reason for the creepy cages.
When your consciousness is in another's subconsciousness, your psyches will inevitably intermingle. Just as the client's mind can affect you, you will see parts of yourself reflected in the mind of the client. Tread lightly and tread carefully.
Hey, there's a cupcake. That has a heart on the bottom of it. Alright, somehow I think I'm gonna have to remember that. Okay. Ooh, what's this? I guess it's just a rock. It's a something. Anywho. Or maybe it's a mushroom. Who knows? Good night, Revan. Sleepy dragon. Tell what that is. Yeah, that's the weirdest looking tree I've ever seen. I take that back. Oh, look. Trees with lollipops.
At Neurostalgia, we take great measures to ensure our neuroprober's safety as best we can. However, you are about to proceed through a highly dangerous area that you must face alone. If the client's subconscious becomes too volatile, you will be automatically removed from this area of the mind and taken to a safer area of the mind. Use this as an opportunity to collect yourself. When you're ready, you will be able to easily return to where you left off to battle the darkness and chaos that has taken root in the client's subconscious.
Good night, Trogdor, you sleepy dragon. Trying to scare me. Yeah. Good night. So there's a pattern to this. And I just got scared. I'm stuck. Gee, Hansel Gretel. Thank you. That's gonna go in here somewhere. Oops, not really what I wanted to do. Stick that there for a minute.
This is a simulation, not an actual client. Clients are very nuanced, but this sim may be more simple than you think. Trust your gut based on the clues you saw.
This stupid little bar interrupts what I'm looking at, so it's harder for me to see. Still think it's this one.
Thank you.
fear. All right, I think I did it.
Oh my god. Oh my god. It's all rushing back to me. It's so awful, and I don't want to remember, but yes, I now know the face of my demon. My sister and I, we were taken out into the woods by my stepmother for one of her nighttime walks. We'd usually find our way back by leaving a trail of whatever we could grab before the walk. Marbles, pieces of paper, even pebbles. However, one night, she took us deep, deep into the woods. We brought some bread to leave a trail of crumbs, but all the forest creatures must have eaten them. We were lost, so lost. We tried to find our way back, but it was so dark, and we were in a very strange part of the woods. We were lost for days, hungry and tired. We finally found a house and were so hopeful that someone might be able to help us. That house, though, that house was no ordinary house. It looked like candy, and there was something off about it. We shouldn't have gone in, but we did. It was a prison for lost children like us. There was a woman in the house who would fatten her prisoners up and try to eat them, and that was going to be our fate. I was first. She tricked me into getting close to the oven, and before I knew it, I was inside. If it weren't for my clever sister Gretel pulling me out in time, I would have been burned alive. We escaped that house and found our way home. After that, things started to get better. Our awful stepmother passed away, and my family came into some wealth. I guess we just forgot about those events. I mean, how could you live with those images and memories inside your mind? Then again, they were always there. The old woman still torturing us beyond memory, beyond time. However, I can now confront my past, confront this trauma. Thank you. It is better to know than not to know.
Sim, anyway. Walk around and see what else is here. Probably nothing. Let's see. Dr. James Show. Okay. Sector A. Apparently I'm not allowed to go in there. Sector C. We have A and Z. Garden area. Elevators. Apparently I can't go that way yet. Plants and stuffs. All right. So we got the sim done. This is. All righty, that's interesting. Okay. This is. You've got to be kidding me. Dr. M. Sharks. Dr. C. Heights. Dr. F. Fear. Clowns. Empty square. Oh, that's just the new snakes. Crowds. Spiders. And we're back. Alrighty. Oh wait, I missed this one. Mannequins. Okay. Wait, is that one really? Yeah, those two were the same. Needles. Alrighty. Interesting. Okay. Just places you can visit. Got it. Where we go into actually see the patient. Go in here.
Try closing your eyes and focusing on slow breaths for 5 deep inhales and exhales.
Okay, so I guess if this gets too intense for you, you can come here and relax for a minute. Gotcha. Totem dude. Ugliest thing ever. Eh. Guess it's not really ugly, just don't like it. Too bad they won't let you design your own office. That would be awesome. Alright, client select. Alright, so what we got here? Time to go into an actual client's mind. See what really happens.
I guess I don't know where to start. Anywhere? Okay. Well, I've been a real estate agent for the past 20 years. I graduated from a small college, just about half an hour from here, actually. I've never been married. I have no siblings. I've always loved cats. I hate churches. I guess I've always been a little bit of a loner. I really hate how people look at me. Especially lately. I've honestly felt pretty, I don't know, normal. Until about a couple of years ago, after my mother's death. That was when things started to come apart. Do you ever feel like people are just staring at you? Like when you walk into a room and everyone knows something they're not telling you? I don't know, I just feel awful when I'm around people. Guilty, angry at... I had a pretty happy childhood. My dad passed away when I was just a kid. My mother told me that he died in a car accident. I don't remember that day, though. Maybe I was too young. My dad and I always played jigsaw puzzles together. He was a businessman. I remember him always talking about the family finances. My mom and I were never all that close, but I do miss her. She loved her wine. Lord, I don't know why this is happening to me. I was the perfect little girl.
Perfect little girl, my butt, I say. Alrighty then.
How late are they?
I have it under control.
Why can't you... Oh, why can't you pay the bills?
I'm trying.
It's your fault.
You pay them then.
Chessboard. Book. This is nothing. That is a big fireplace. Sheesh. Of course, this room seems like it's a little oversized. There's nothing in here. Did I go up to this thing? Nope. Maybe I did. Picture mom and dad. And the daughter. Gotta be like a bathroom or something. Kitchen. Radio. Oh. Everything's so big.
Lights off and go to sleep, honey.
To see the dark, you must kill the light. Damn. Okay. I'm supposed to probably put these somewhere, huh? Thank you. Phantom Mummy was an alcoholic. Any sort of clues around here that I might be missing? Thinking one of them is a gun. Let's see, can we turn the light? No. Gun is the last one. That would make sense. Try that. Let's see. Didn't I try that already? Maybe not. Okay. Nope. Okay, just thought of something. Or maybe not. Worth a try. So I realized that there were some different things that you could drink on here, like tea, milk, technically fruit. You juice it. Definitely a gun involved. Was worth a shot. Solutions. That which lies before you. Can be realized through that which is left behind you. Because the gun permit's over there. Tease back there. Sorrow from killing somebody or getting shot or somebody dying. Nope, can't go through the door. You spilled. Oh, I am an idiot. I even looked at those two. Oh my god. Okay. I was like, why is there a picture of cows? Thank you. if you pay attention to the stupid portraits, milk, gun permit, and sorrow. Alrighty. Oh my god. I hate this because it makes me dizzy. Ugh.
I did my best.
How late are you?
I have it under control.
Why can't you pay the bills?
I'm trying.
It's your fault.
You pay them then.
Okay, so I can only go as far as these stupid things. Is that all the puzzles? Nope, there's one. Looks like there's one more over there. No, I guess that went there. Huh.
Thank you.
piece still missing. Oh, there it is. What have you done? They know. Need help take a shower. I should be missing some stuff. Let's see. Pick out some of these letters. Thank you. I was trying to figure out what those words were to mean. I picked out bath or bathe, but I couldn't figure out what the rest of it was. Let's see if this works. There's a face. This turning is really slow. Okay, that's a good end. Pushing these things have to do with anything. I don't get it. That's where I came in at, so... Okay. Okay, that just goes in a big circle. Alright. There's milk everywhere! Can't escape the milk. I feel like I just went in one big frickin' circle. Okay, so that's a dead end. God, if anyone is afraid of milk, this is definitely not the place to be. Alright. Okay, all the milk's gone. There's a door up there. White spot on the floor. And we're back in the ghastly kitchen. Crying now? Is this room still the same? Nope, it's not gonna let me. Oh, joy. I gotta go back upstairs. Alright. Or maybe not. Oh, I guess I can always come back out here. Oh! Nice to know. Got three more left. I bet I can't go back in there. Awesome. Alright. Where to next? Tea party. Oh, we know where I'm going next. Ugh. onlookers watching me run across the street. Alright. And go!
Stay out of the way! Remember the past! Stay out of the way!
Thank you. heard a door open. Maybe it was that one shitting. Oh. Missing one more. Oh, not the twisty stairs again. Everybody's staring at me. now I gotta go.
Thank you.
I thought it would be the letters, but maybe it's not. But there was an awful lot of milk.
Playing tea party out in my yard one day, and I got thirsty, so I went inside to pour myself a glass of milk. It slipped from my hands and spilled everywhere. I went to tell my mom, but she was taking a shower, so I went to tell my father. He was upstairs in his bedroom, and when I opened the door, he had a gun in his mouth. He looked at me, and then he shot himself. He shot himself. It was so terrible. I couldn't remember what happened. So my mom, she must have made up the story of the car accident to protect me from ever remembering. But I guess I always knew that was a lie. I always knew.
I didn't even see that before. See what's next. Ooh, 100% explored. Woohoo. All right. Oh wait, that was the intro sim. That's right. One 100% explored. Ooh, we've got a snow spa. Let's go check it out. Oh, that's the way out. Okay.
Try closing your eyes and focusing on slow breaths for 5 deep inhales and exhales.
Okay, so apparently if you stop for a moment, it'll kick that in and tell you, just breathe. Gets us out. All right, that one sounds fun, but I think I'm going to stop here tonight and then pick it up next time with this one. All right, thanks for watching and have a great night.